Welcome. In this class, we would be discussing on the internal security, and this is one of the major topics. You have at least 1 to 2 questions that could be expected from this section. So the first is B.N. Krishna committee. This committee is on data protection. Now, with increasing amount of data processors and the online systems that are being used, protection of data has become a major concern, and therefore this panel suggested a data protection bill in 2018. Government should notify categories of personal data that would be considered as critical, and this is one of the major recommendations under the Shri Krishna committee report, where you have talked about the programs which are not in the best interest of children, the programs which are targeted advertisements, those which have behavioral monitoring. So all those kind of data analysis would be taken into account. The National Registrar of Citizenship or citizens is very, very important. This whole thing started with Assam Gan Parishad and the All Assam Students Union back in 1951. Since then, we are trying to prepare a register based on the census of 1951 since then. The idea is to identify the bona fide citizens of India, and those who fail to register would be deemed as an illegal migrants. So detection, deletion and deportation of the illegal migrants would become simpler. So NRC has been one of the major strengths that people have been working on, and since 2017 we are leading to the upgradation of the NRC mainly in Assam. The next is Gravity Rat. This is a kind of malware which was designed by Pakistani hackers. Rat means remote access Trojan. So it is a Trojan which is capable of being controlled remotely, and therefore it is very, very difficult to trace. This has been developed as a part of Gravity Rat, which is an advanced persistent threat. Now, the infliction time is very short term, so it could damage the various files which are attached to the Microsoft Office, and therefore anti-malware capabilities are important to diagnose it. Now, Disha portal. Now, this Disha portal is not the portal which deals with education. That's the Deeksha portal. So, make sure you are not confused. Disha portal is the Digital Information Security on Healthcare Act. This was drafted back in March. The idea was to generate, regulate and store information for health data of an individual, and personally identifiable information could be recorded. So, National Electronic Health Authority would set up this in line with the state authorities. Very prompt patient delivery services could be given. Proper care and coordination with medical professionals could be brought, and clinical approach could be taken into consideration. Rajiv Goba committee has been laid down for the incidences of lynching. This is one of the most important reports that have been let down after the fake post and the rumors relating to lynching that have come up on social media, which has created mob violence. So this portal is really, really important to help establish a kind of nodal body that could bring in the crime records in the country. The next is DNA Technology Use and Application Regulation Bill 2018. It aims to expand the usage of DNA-based forensic technology for justice delivery system. So take out the sample, DNA profiling, DNA records, identifying the person. So for use in forensic technology, this technique would be highly useful. Government has empowered to jail person up to 3 years or fine up to 1 lakh for those who leak any such kind of sensitive information or data. Recently in Pune, cooperative bank services were attacked under cyber attack. So you have under Supreme Court directive, privacy as a fundamental right now. So these cyber attacks or cyber crimes have become really, really sensitive issues. You have Cyber for All, which is a kind of secure and inclusive cyberspace for sustainable development, which was the first ever conference that was conducted. So cyber security has been one of the major issues. Gorkhaland is a very important aspect. Now, people in Darjeeling, the Nepali speaking people in India, are who are known as Gorkhas. So protection of Gorkha, they are talking about Gorkha land, and similarly the Indian origin people in Nepal are known as Madhehi. Madhehis are basically lying in the Tarai area of Nepal, So it's one of the oldest movements that had been running since 1907. The region of Gorkhaland, the protection of Gorkhas and Gorkhaland has been one of the major issues. Darjeeling is one of the important aspects of economy in terms of tea production, in terms of tourism. And it's a kind of chicken corridor which connects it to the remaining countries. The next is the Nationalist Socialist Council of Nagaland. This was formed in 1980 by an extremist who did not accept the Shillong Accord during that time, and this was an accord between Delhi and Naga National Council for a separatist state. So that started back in 1950s. Later on, the Nationalist Socialist Council of Nagaland was split based on the Myanmar's peace process initiative, and finally you have a chairman that has been appointed after 3 years under this. Abhinandan Vardhaman had been kept captive in Pakistan. He was the Indian Air Force Wing Commander. Now, what is important for Abhinandan's stories is you have the Geneva Convention and Red Cross. So, we have taken lectures on those separately. Very, very important. The three protocols under Geneva and the four Geneva Conventions. The third Geneva Convention talks about prisoners of war. So there could be a direct question about the four conventions of Geneva, the three protocols under Geneva Convention. Very, very important, highly applicable for your upcoming examination. So what is Red Cross, Red Crescent? We have covered that all in that video. So you would have the links below, just refer that. And we would be covering many more important topics for your examination. Every time you have at least 10 to 20 questions that come up from the expected series that we release. So cover these topics carefully. Most important for your examination perspective. Have a wonderful day ahead.